You done it. Anyone read the intro or react some stuff? On me or?
Oh, it was posted out on.
Oh, okay, cool. Basically, just a quick rundown of what I do, guys. I've been asked to come talk to you guys tonight about mining specifically, but happy to go into anything to do with trading or any other cryptos or any that sort of stuff during Q&A. So I started off in Forex markets previously to cryptocurrencies. So I used to be technical analysis trader for Forex, and then moved into cryptocurrencies because they're extremely volatile, and volatility is key. Volatility means money to us when we're trading and so forth, so that's why I'm in the crypto space at the moment. Through my crypto journey, started out doing trading stuff, okay, and then moved into mining also, and then now into something else called masternodes, which is kind of similar to mining, but we'll touch base on that. Okay, so from a mining perspective, is anyone in the room currently mining cryptocurrencies at the moment? No? Okay. So I bought a machine for you today, guys, just to have a look at. So this is one of the most popular kind of, these are called ASIC miners. Now these are dedicated to mining a certain coin per model. And this one is from a company called Bitmain. Has anybody heard of Bitmain before?
Yeah.
Okay, so they're basically the largest manufacturer for mining in the world at the moment. So if anyone's thinking of getting one of these machines, I'll just turn this on for you so you can have a listen to how loud it is. Because this will probably, if you're thinking of buying any of these, this might change your mind into getting a GPU set up, okay? So we'll just like do a little start procedure. Doesn't need to plug into the network or anything like that for that to happen. So from a mining point of view, if you want to get involved with mining, guys, there's two types of mining. There's these machines here, which are specialized for certain tasks, certain coins, certain algorithms, I should say. Or there's graphic card mining rig setups, which you guys might have seen as well, with like, you know, your towers with like 6 cards or 10 cards. You can get up to like 19 cards these days into a single rig. Now, I started off with GPU mining, so I'm just going to show you guys my old setup.
When it comes to crypto,
thank you very much.
There's a place that gathers Ethereum.
There you go. It's alive! Yes, mine farm is alive. Check it out. So basically what we've got is the bottom row is running, just switching it up. Okay, that was mining Ethereum back in the day. Does everyone know Ethereum coin? Okay. That was mining Ethereum back in probably late 2016 when Ethereum was about $10 a coin. Okay. That's how loud that thing is. Have you had like 10 of them in your house? Okay. They are very efficient at what they do, they are very good at what they do. But for obvious reasons, noise is mainly a determining factor for people running them at home. Okay, and mining these days at the moment is, with the market being very bearish at the moment, mining is almost break-even for a lot of coins currently at the moment. So a lot of people previously in a bullish market, they look at buying mining machines and all sort of thing because they want to get a daily profit turnover. The problem with that is mining is a long-term thing, okay? So if you're looking to get into mining, you really don't want to just buy mining hardware based on a daily profit level, because what we're looking for cryptocurrency over a long-term growth period is actually a substantial increase in the market, okay? So market cap terms, we're trading at, I think last time I looked, it was, let's say, rough average around $300 billion at the moment. We peaked to about $850, $900 billion back in December, January period. So we've dropped, you know, a couple of times below what we were previously. That's when everyone started buying a crap load of these things because they saw the daily average growth. You know, you could make $30, $40 per day mining a coin and selling a coin off, you know, every day kind of thing. Those returns at the moment are almost nothing at the moment. But you know, over the next few years, I believe that once we get more regulation in place, you're going to get the big investor guys coming in, you know, the big hedge fund guys, which are trading hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars in bank sectors and so forth. If we get a slither of that money into the cryptocurrency market, which will happen, you know, we're looking at a potential 5, 10, 20, 30, 50 time growth of the overall market cap, what we're looking at right now. So where everyone here is the extremely, extremely early adopters. There was a study done recently, I think there was about 0.5% of the population even owned crypto to begin with. So anyone that's got crypto currently, well done, very good. And yeah, from mining specifically point of view, if you want to do mining, guys, you really need to do mining for a long-term growth, okay? So the best way to get your mining rewards, mining profits are set up your miners and so forth, right? And you want to try and offset your electricity costs out of your own pocket. So majority of people are getting this crypto, probably normally, you know, most people have normal day jobs, whatever else, businesses you run in, all that sort of thing. Try and offset the electricity out of your own pocket for 6 to 12 months, okay? And you want to sell your coins off. If you're mining coins, you want to sell your coins off in a bullish market, okay? Because when we're in a bullish market, our coins obviously peaked in value, and that's how I got a large gain from, say, Ethereum back in the day, because everyone was telling me I was crazy for spending X amount of money on hardware, because Ethereum's changing to what they would call in proof of stake model at the time. That still hasn't happened, okay? It's still proof of work, which means it's still a mineable coin, so it needs to be mined. And, you know, I even had a friend of mine who turned their mining rigs off when we got down to about $10 a coin, because it was almost break even back then, right? So I just kept mining away, and then we peaked to like over $1,200 US, you know, back in the last bullish market. So from $10 to over $1,200, you know, that's a pretty significant gain. So you can see why mining from a long-term perspective can be a very profitable thing, but it also doesn't mean that you can just mine and get a daily or weekly or monthly income from it, okay? So if you're looking to do mining, because if you're gonna just buy mining machines and mine and then sell off as a weekly dollar value or monthly dollar value, you might as well just skip mining altogether, buy the coins themselves and hold the coins and wait for the increase in value from the coins, okay? So if you're gonna think about mining or doing anything to do with mining at all, definitely look at from a long-term aspect. I normally tell people 12 to 18 months, okay? If you can't offset your electricity for 12 to 18 months for your power costs, don't even think about mining. It's pointless, because by the time you buy the hardware and all the rest of it, if you're just gonna do that, you know, small time frame gain where you're looking for that weekly paycheck or whatever, it's not worth it. It's definitely not worth it. So no one is currently mining at the moment. Was there anyone thinking of getting into mining or anything? Or yeah.
So I've thought about it, but
it's
too hard.
Oh, you tried it out too hard.
Well, I've thought about it, and I've done a little bit of research on that, but I'm not particularly techie. So
yeah. Okay. Yeah. So from a techie, non-techie perspective, I'll just touch base on that. With your graphics card setups like this, the video I just showed you guys, obviously I come from an IT background, so I built all that myself. I maintain it, I run it, I do all that sort of stuff yourself, because you've got to obviously build the rig, set up the software on the rig, you've got to look for coins that you want to mine, change mining softwares and so forth. If you are interested in mining, guys, Zilch TV is my YouTube channel. There's a crap load of free content on there regarding mining, crypto, Bitcoin, masternodes, everything else that I do as well. And I do actually have videos on here how to build a rig from scratch. Okay, so if you are thinking of having a go, or even building a computer, for example, there's videos on there on how to build your own mining rigs, how to set up the software for the mining rigs if you want to do a graphic card setup. Okay, all the videos are in there. From a non-techie perspective, if you did want to get into mining, these things are definitely the go. Because they come as is. You literally just need to plug in the power supply connectors. They can only plug in one way. You can't break it, you can't screw it up. And all that is power and network. So you do obviously need a network connection like your desktop on your network. So
what's your daily consumption? Electricity consumption, My daily consumption at home is about 220 kilowatts or something a day. Yeah. So quite a lot.
And what would that be?
That one there, so this specific model uses about 800 watts of power. Okay.
And what do you actually get out of it per day, say, in exchange?
It varies. So there's a website called What to Mine. Where's that keyboard going?
So did you say Bitcoin or what do you mine?
No. So that one is a Litecoin miner. But I'm currently mining Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dash. Electronium. I think that's it at the moment. So this website here, whatsmine.com. If you are going to look into mining, guys, this website here is the website you want to look at, okay? Because it shows you all the coins, different coins that you can mine, and it lets you put in your whether you've got GPU miners. So GPU miners can do all these different algorithms. Okay, so all coins have their own, they use a certain algorithm. Okay, and each coin, let's say GPU miner for example, these algorithms are good for GPUs. Okay, whereas if you tried to set up one of these machines, which is an ASIC, which is this machine here, ASIC machine, if you try to set up one of those machines to mine one of these coins, it's not efficient to do so. So effectively the coin maker or the coin developer, if they're going to set up a coin that can be mined, they try and make it obviously beneficial to a certain member of people. So some people are very anti these machines because there's one big manufacturer in the world and they're from China and they care about where they come from, and these guys try to build these things to be more efficient than everyone else and everyone hates that. So that's why you've got two different kind of types of sites. So I don't care about the site, I'm just in it for the profits. Yeah, I'm not picky, I don't care. And this allows you to put in all your different hash rates and your power consumption, and it tells you, say, your daily cost, and it works out, what sort of profit levels and so on and so forth. So to give you an example, coins. My latest mining video on here, which is about this Z9 mini miner, which is a new miner that has come out recently. So this is another thing with mining is if there is a new miner that comes out, a new type of miner that is going to be better or more efficient than other miners, if you can get on the very first order batch, that's where you're going to get your largest profit, right? Profit region, because if there's a miner that comes out, say these ones here for example, that little tiny unit, it's actually smaller than that unit as well, on the certain algorithm that one little unit can mine, is actually more efficient than my whole old 60 graphic card setup. Because the technology that is put in to build that specific unit for that algorithm has now been increased and it's better and so on and so forth. So as new technologies do come out, it does get, it does obviously push old technology out. It's like PCs, a PC is outdated within 6 months.
Because I looked into it once and it recommended to get a group of people together to pull together to do the mining. In Bitcoin, say.
Yeah.
Because it's sort of like a race.
So mining pools, so everybody now mines on mining pools, whereas back when, say, Bitcoin first started, you could solo mine, and what it means is you get a bunch of different mining pools. What that means is everybody, let's say this whole group of people here, we all set our miners to mine to one certain point, right? If any of us in the room found the network block, we would then all share the reward equally based on how much work we put into finding that block. Now, many, 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 many years ago when Bitcoin was first in existence, you could literally find Bitcoin blocks with, say, your average computer at home. Whereas the way the technology is built, over time it gets harder and harder. The more people that mine, it increases the difficulty, so then it gets harder, so you get less reward. And the pools came into play, so people weren't running their machines for like a year and getting no reward. Because if you just, if I try to mine Bitcoin myself, for example, I may never ever find a block. So for me,
I still can't quite get to how do you find that.
So it's just so these machines are basically the way the technology is in the coin is these machines basically solve all the mathematical equations in the coin, and then once it finds the correct combination, that block is then released or built, and then because that gets released or built, you then get the reward of the coin for finding it. So mining is basically building and securing the network of the coin. So if we had, Bitcoin, for example, every single miner turned off their operation in the world, no transactions would get sent. So from a mining perspective, this is why we're kind of getting to the way Bitcoin is at the moment and the way price is at the moment, where mining is almost getting to the point of being break even. Now, obviously, the cheaper countries, say China, they pay roughly 4 to 5 cents per kilowatt, whereas in Australia here, we're paying about 16 or 17 cents. I basically US because the returns are in US dollars. So our US dollar per kilowatt is around about 16 to 17 cents per kilowatt, and where you get the likes of China having 4 to 5 cents per kilowatt, they can afford to run when Bitcoin price is a lot lower, for example, and still make a profit. I know most US states are anywhere between sort of 8 to 10 cents per kilowatt, so even US, for example, is still, they're still getting good profits at the moment with Bitcoin mining and stuff. In Australia, Bitcoin mining is pretty much on the verge of break even. Now, I'm still mining with all of my machines. Some of my machines are even in like negative, like I'm actually mining at a loss with a very little amount of my machines at the moment. The reason for that is I obviously believe in cryptocurrency, and I'm happy to pay a little bit of loss now for a potential massive gain in a couple of years' time. So I've seen it before, it's happened before on certain coins like Ethereum a couple of years ago. It was at that same point when it got so low that it was basically break even. Like you go, oh, well, I'm paying this electricity and I'm not able to sell it for anything, so I might as well turn it off. And then the coin jumps. Yeah.
So you're saying when you make a loss, you mean you make a loss, but if you were to convert your crypto into fiat, are you making a loss? Or
correct. If I was to mine and sell my profit basically every day,
yeah,
I would actually be
losing
money. Not on everything, but there is some miners that I'm still running that are running that. When I say a loss, I mean like 50 cents a day or something. Like it's stupidly small, but when you get massive mining farms in other countries, for example, you know, China and the US, if their profit levels were to get down so low where it was almost break even for them to run a massive warehouse of miners, well then what happens? Yeah, still. I mean, I have solar and all this stuff as well. So that obviously does help, but not a lot. Like I've got a 5 kilowatt solar system, and it generates anywhere between 25 and 40 kilowatts a day, and I'm already using over 200. So it kind of helps a little bit. But
you need to be able to increase that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean that would be optimum, but then you also get the likes of like solar farms and stuff actually selling their electricity higher than what they'd be able to a miner farm kind of thing in Australia. I think there's a large mining farm up here at Sunshine Coast. One of the largest in the Southern Hemisphere, actually. Yeah. Yeah, so obviously something like that would be very beneficial if you had contacts in that sort of region. If you get some sort of cheaper electricity, sometimes you can obviously get deals and things like that. Yeah, exactly, right. So from a mining perspective, that's why we're kind of at a from a Bitcoin perspective now. So this is where I'm a technical analysis trader, which means I read charts, I plot trend lines, I do all my technical analysis to see where I think price is heading, or if this happens, I'm going to do this outcome kind of thing. So from a technical analysis point of view at the moment, Bitcoin for me is actually heading lower. But from a fundamental analysis point of view, we're kind of already hit our bottom. Now, my basis for that are kind of a few things. It relies around regulation a lot, as I said before. With if we get even one major institution in the world to put a portion of their hundreds of billions of dollars into, say, Bitcoin, you know, we're reaching new all-time highs straight away, instantly. But then from a technical point of view, from a technical analysis point of view, we're still in a bearish market, obviously. So this is kind of where mining comes into the fundamental analysis as well, where if we get too low a price on Bitcoin, that's kind of an unknown zone at the moment, because since Bitcoin's inception, we haven't actually hit that level where people have not been making profits. Okay, so that's where it kind of, who knows what happens. That's where we kind of go, oh, what's going to happen, that this and that. So from a fundamental point of view, that's also why I see that as our bottom, because I don't see us going into that negative zone for everybody, because literally, you know, I mean, you've got the massive players who have been mining Bitcoin for years and years. They obviously could run at a loss for extended period of time. They could run at a loss for 6, 12, 24 months, whatever. But how long would someone run at a loss before they change their mind?
But they already bought all their hardware, so they're not really...
But they still have to pay for electricity. So
if
price gets too low and they can't afford to run the electricity and get enough profit to continue to run, what then kind of happens? So that's why not only Bitcoin, but you start to see other coins come out where you don't need to have a proof of work sense. You don't need to have a miner. You can have it based on running sort of nodes. So if we kind of jump from mining to what's called master nodes. Now master nodes are, I've got some videos on here on master node setup and so forth. Master nodes are kind of like mining, but instead of actually purchasing physical hardware, you're buying a stake in a coin. So you've got the coins, right? You keep them in your wallet. You set up a server to act as a node, which allows transactions and so on and so forth to be processed through your node. And your node then acts as security for the network, because you are a node which can talk to other transactions and processes. And from that, you get a reward. Okay, and it's kind of like if you were to buy a stock and you were to get like a dividend reward kind of thing. Like, that's how master nodes work. So you get other coins. So I've got a couple of Syscoin master nodes running. So Syscoin for me is very good fundamentally. So I'm running a couple of their master nodes, and yeah, you get like a reward every so often in your wallet, a certain amount of coins. So if you're looking into something like mining or even anything else to give you some sort of kind of passive return within crypto, master nodes are probably the best thing. Because they reward you in, let's say you have a Syscoin master node, they reward you in giving you additional actual Syscoin. So from a market perspective, once you've got the coin, it really doesn't matter what the price of the coin is, because you're actually generating that coin itself. You're not generating based on a Satoshi value. You're not generating based on a dollar value. You're generating based on that coin unit value itself. And then once we head back into a bullish market cycle, you can then offload that coin if you want at a profit. And even through a bearish market cycle, you're actually generating additional coins rather than having to try and trade them. So a lot of people that I talk to about trading and so on and so forth, they want to learn how to trade. Trading is obviously very difficult. It's not easy, I'm not going to lie, it is difficult. It's not easy, but they have a go at it. They kind of get, you know, they have a go. They kind of say, oh, it's too hard or whatever, and end up losing money or so on and so forth. So I point them to then masternodes. So masternodes are probably the next best thing. If you don't want to learn trading, you don't want to do trading, masternodes are probably the next best thing.
That's what we're using for our DeFi digitally mined assets,
yep.
commodities. It's a proof of stake.
Proof of stake model.
It's
that's
a
right.
wallet, and yep. that's where your investment goes, is into that unit,
yep.
and it's constantly making.
And then you get a reward based on staking that coin.
You're staking it, but you're providing, like you said, the
yep.
the consensus.
The consensus. Yeah.
And witness.
You're securing the.
You're securing the
securing
network.
Securing the network,
yeah.
rather than having to build. The
but it's
network.
Really simple. You just buy in, and then
yep.
we put ours in the web, in the cloud.
Yep. Yep. Yeah. So it's very simple, and the cost of. The cost of setting up masternodes and so on and so forth, you do have to run what's called a virtual private server, but a virtual private server is literally like $5 a month, okay, as opposed to electricity costs and so on and so forth. So to run a masternode, it is definitely cheaper than buying mining equipment and running mining equipment. But I like to do it.
Would you say that this is more exciting, there's more volatility in this, and that's kind of like plodding along, just making a little bit?
It's a bit of everything, because at the end of the day, realistically, I trade all the coins that I generate anyway. So from a mining perspective, that's good because I'm constantly generating coins that I'm mining, but then I'm trading those coins to try to increase my overall revenue as well. From a masternode point of view, it's good because that's, you know, like the mining, it's basically passive as well. Like once you have the coins, you're just generating more
but
coins.
That's really set it and forget it.
It is.
You pay your
yeah.
bill for your VM.
Yeah.
And it's just making you money.
The only problem with the masternode is the setup. So
well, we pre-configure them and just spin them up. People get a unique wallet ID.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
that's it.
Yeah. That's great.
And
so
they can actually pick how
what,
good.
What coin is that?
It's a variant on Blackcoin. So it's
okay.
It's pure coin, zero coin Blackcoin.
Yeah, yeah. I was going to say I run another node, which is called Alko, ALQO, and what they do is they provide the hosting for you. So you pay a slightly higher fee than say five. You pay like $8 a month or $10 a month, whatever the fee is. They do all the setup, the hosting, all that sort of stuff. They email you back an instruction. You type a couple of lines of command and you send that back. And then that's kind of like your whole node setup kind of thing. So there are coins out there which are good. So some of them are much better than others with the hosting side of things and the setup. This one, for example, this Vivo coin. One, so this is a very cheap masternode to get into at the moment, and recently they've developed a setup script from the VPS side. So you set up the VPS, you run a command line, and it sets up the whole thing for you because it runs on like a Linux backend. So it is probably more on the techie side than mining, because
yeah.
mining like that for example, you literally plug it in, plug internet into it, log into it once. Configure
yeah.
it, and then it's literally plug and play. Yeah.
Would you say from running a node perspective that it, because you're actually investing in those coins to begin with, that it's very important to choose a coin?
Correct.
That
yeah.
It's going to go up in value.
Yeah. So it is more. So from a node perspective, it is. It can be more risky. Okay. Because obviously with a mining piece of hardware, you have. That does a certain algorithm, okay? So what the algorithm means is you might be able to mine 5, 10, 20 coins with that. So if a coin disappears or dies off or a team abandons it or whatever, you can switch, okay? With a masternode, you're buying that specific coin. So yeah, it's definitely important to do a lot of research and a lot of homework on that coin, the team, making sure they're active, making sure they're meeting their roadmap, you know, making sure that they're up to date with all their social media, like their Facebook's active, their Twitter's active, all those sorts of things. Because once you obviously buy the coin, if they then do a runner or the team disappeared or whatever, if that coin's value then tanks out the arse, you're left with almost nothing, you know what I mean? Like you're going to end up with a fairly significant loss. So yes, masternodes, obviously, definitely more risky. But the reward can be just as great. So the good thing about nodes during a market cycle like we're in now, like we're in a bearish market cycle, it's much cheaper to buy now. You still get the reward based on the actual coins themselves, so you still get a fixed amount of coins every now and again. Whereas mining And even trading, for example, trading is obviously much easier in a bullish market. Mining is much better in a bullish market because you're getting a much better return. Whereas these ones are kind of better in a bearish market because you pick up the coins cheap, but then once we go into a bullish market, you can offload the coins at a much greater profit as well. So it's important to, I think learn about all aspects of crypto, from trading, masternodes, and mining as well, and develop, you know, work out which you like best and which is going to suit whatever you guys kind of want to do the best. Yeah.
With regards to mining, well, that's a plug-and-play type device, but say, would it be effective to use my child like internet connection where I've got mobile broadband? Do you think that could be
No, not really. No, I mean, we're kind of at the... During a very bullish market, it probably would be, but at the moment, it probably wouldn't be. Based on the fact that, say for example, that video I showed you guys before with my big setup, like those cards are all clocked to a certain level, they're all chopped and changed to min-max the value based on what electricity price you're paying versus what hash rate you're getting and so on and so forth. Whereas with your normal sort of desktop PC at home, it's kind of like, yeah, not really designed to do that. You'd end up using a lot more electricity than what you generate based on your hash rate. So yeah, if you're going to do mining, do it right and use specialized hardware.
Oh, yeah, I actually meant with one of those ant miners or such, but with kind of average internet, would it still work?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it uses very, very little internet usage. Yeah, so bandwidth-wise, it uses almost nothing. It's literally like mining, for example, is kind of, it's almost like sending ping requests across the network. So it uses very, very little data. Like you can run, you know, at one point in time I had about 10, like you've seen that video, I had about 10 different setups running, and I noticed absolutely no difference at all in my normal internet usage.
After the node sync to the blockchain, because during the sync,
oh, well, with the mining, you don't have to actually sync the blockchain.
You're just a node.
I mine directly to an exchange most of the time. So then my coins are already on the exchange and I can set my cell level values at whatever I want to sell them at. Okay. The only thing I haven't really touched on with mining is where you can be very profitable with mining is, as you guys know, we're always constantly getting new coins coming out. Okay, so we've gone from like 600 coins at the beginning, at the middle of last year to now we're up to like 1600 coins. Most of those have been developed through ICOs and so forth, but some of them are also released as just new coins generated. There was one where I was very fortunate, and this is again keeping on top of your cryptocurrency, keeping on top of your crypto news. Okay, there was an ICO I bought into, and the coin was called Electronium. Okay. And I bought into Electronium for like, I don't know, it was only a small amount, like 0.2 Bitcoin or something like that. It got me about 150,000 coins or whatever for the ICO phase, right? They were set to release their ICO tokens at the same time that they enabled their mining. Now, something went wrong with the ICO token release, but the mining side still went ahead.
Oh, yeah, you need coins.
But... That was the same coin, but the token itself hadn't been released to the ICO buyers. So I basically followed what was happening. I knew that they were going to enable mining at some point. I was like a hawk, like waiting for this thing to happen, waiting for me to find a pool and so on and so forth. And I literally went in and reconfigured all of my rigs to this new Electronium mining pool. And I was able to generate, you know, 100,000 coins in like a 24-hour period. Which after 2 days, the exact same setup was only generating about 2,000 or 3,000 coins. Okay? So because I was very onto it and ready, waiting, configured all my setup straight away, the reason I got so much reward was because there wasn't many other miners on the network mining at the same time as me. So when we were finding more blocks on the network, I was getting heaps of the reward. Okay, so that's where mining can be extremely profitable, if you find new coins. There is a website to do that. It's called, where's that keyboard? It's called Bitcoin Talk,
okay.
which is where, so this is a good website for people, bitcointalk.com or .org? .org? So what most people do is when they create a new coin or when they're developing a new coin, they do what's called an announcement. Okay, and the announcement is to kind of like tell people about the coin, you know, give all their social media stuff, kind of like introduce the team, introduce the token economics, like how many tokens are going to be minted or set up or pre-mined and lots of stuff. So this announcement section here under altcoins, obviously anything that isn't Bitcoin is an altcoin. So under this announcement section here, okay, you get basically announcements of all new coins that are coming out, that are being generated and being created. So if you're on top of these type of things, this is where you're going to be able to generate more profits as well, because you can go through and pick a project that you like, pick a project that suits your hardware, for example, if you want to do mining, make sure it's the right algorithm for your setup. You can mine that new coin. Now, just because it's a new coin doesn't mean it's going to be profitable, doesn't mean it's going to be good. So it is a bit of a gamble, because you don't know if that team is actually going to progress through with what they're saying they're going to do, or whether it's even going to get listed on an exchange, and so on and so forth. But if you use a portion of your mining setup to do things like this, that can turn very good profits as well. Okay, so have a look in there. So bitcointalk.org, have a look at the announcement section. That's basically a lot of new coins that are coming out. Okay, there's a lot of crap in there as well. So you do have to go through crap to find the good stuff.
And don't click on any links that any of these.
Try and you gotta be very careful with your links and what you're clicking on and so on and so forth. Don't go willy-nilly and just click on everything and do not do anything that talks about private keys or anything like that, okay? Don't give anybody private keys or any of that sort of stuff, because they're your own wallet keys. If you give someone your private keys, you've effectively taken out your pocket and gone, my wallet. Okay? So don't give anyone private keys, because you'll end up with nothing in your wallet. So yeah. There are obviously they do monitor this, they do try and maintain it to the best of their ability, but there's obviously stuff that slips through that people just try and scam people with any sort of investment thing. You know, there's scams out there everywhere. So yeah, just be careful with what links and stuff you're clicking on. Based on what we've talked about so far, is anyone got any questions on mining or lost nodes or any of that sort of stuff? Or... Yep. Yeah.
Not so much
mathnode
or the mining, but your TA work, do you have a Twitter channel or anything
which
is sort of
just... Yeah, so I run on Facebook. Sorry. On Facebook, I'm just Zilch TV as well on Facebook. I do run a cryptocurrency training course to do cover basically how I trade, all that sort of stuff. So, it's $500 US entry. For once off costs, there's no ongoings or anything like that. I do live sessions and everything as well, once every couple of weeks. Over kind of like how the market is, what my thoughts are, all that sort of stuff. So yeah, I do run a training course for that as well. So just add Zilch TV on Facebook if you want to have a chat to me. I do have a Facebook group as well. You'll see it under my name or whatever. I have a free group and a paid group. Okay, on Facebook. The free group, I do post up a lot of stuff. Not necessarily a lot of TA stuff, but just crypto stuff in general. So it's more so just keeping people up to date with certain important things or things I'm looking at or keeping up to date with myself as well. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. No worries. Anyone got any general market questions or anything like that as well? Like anything to do with cryptocurrency, doesn't matter what it is.
All right. Well, it looks like we've exhausted all avenues. Mikey, thank you very much. That was awesome. Now, I've had a mental block.